And good evening, everyone. Good evening for our physical attendees, and good night for our virtual attendees as well. And I'm so happy that our virtual attendees are now 9 exactly. So we had 2 attendees, and then we had 11 attendees exactly at 9. So this is our didactic number 23. We have been Dr. Ghada starting introduction to gyne-oncology, and then ovarian cancer module for around 3 months. And then this is the second month or the third month of endometrial cancer module. We are not finishing. We still, all the next month is about endometrial cancer still for September. And tonight, it's our privilege and our honor to have Professor Ghada Izzat Al-Adawi, Professor of Clinical Oncology in Mansoura University Hospital. Dr. Ghada is one of the regular components of the MDT gyne-oncology for the OB-GYN department, I believe, in the gyne-oncology unit. And she has great experience in gynecological cancer management. And again, I know this lecture may be not the best one for the surgeons and the gynecologists. Okay, they don't like to hear the adjuvant therapy and anesthetic and recurrent. And again, as we said in the introduction module, that if you don't want to hear oncology, so don't work as gyne-oncologist. You can't work as gyne-oncology surgeon, as a gynecologist or oncosurgeon, and don't know about the basics and go in depth in the radiation and chemotherapy and all that. So if you are not interested, just quit, because it's all the pathologist should know, the radiologist should know, the clinical oncologist should know about surgery as well, and you must hear this and you must be examined in this. This is part of our fellowship program. So thank you, Dr. Ghada, and the floor is yours.
Thank you, Dr. Basil. أنا إن شاء الله هحاول أكون ضيف خفيف. أنا عارفة إن كلامنا بيبقى صعب شوية.
I'll just excuse you to be speaking in English because we have our attendees from Turkey, from South America, from UK. Okay. So we have many international attendees as well. Yes.
Okay. We start with adjuvant therapy for endometrial cancer. Endometrial cancer is primarily treated with surgery. Adjuvant treatment for endometrial cancer, such as external beam pelvic radiotherapy, vaginal brachytherapy, chemotherapy, or combined chemo and radiotherapy, have been studied in several randomized trials. Okay, the most recently published randomized trial of adjuvant treatment of endometrial carcinoma used a long-standing risk-based approach to enroll patient depend on stage and pathological feature. There is the traditional clinical pathological risk factors, special age, more than 60 or less. More than 60 is a bad prognosis. Okay. Histopathological type, endometrioid or non-endometrioid pathology. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. Myometrial invasion. Stage 1 is highly problematic with different groups. Myometrial invasion is very, very important. Lymphovascular space invasion. Okay. Lymphovascular space invasion is very, very important risk factors. In pathology report, we should review the lymphovascular space invasion. Now, lymphovascular space invasion may be focal, single lymphovascular space is present, or substantial. As substantial evident, it is a multifocal or diffuse arrangement of lymphovascular space invasion or presence of tumor cell in 5 or more lymphovascular spaces. Okay? Lymphovascular space may be focal or substantial. Okay. Focal 1. Substantial, low, more than definitions, may be multifocal or diffuse arrangement or presence of 5 spaces positive. Okay? Lymphovascular space invasion, if it is substantial, there is a great risk of increased recurrence and death. Recently, there is a molecular classification. Dr. Basil, there is a previous lecture last week. Okay. Adjuvant treatment. for what patient? Adjuvant treatment applied to patient with Fugo stage 1 to 4A endometrial cancer who undergo surgery and don't have any macroscopic residual disease. The definition for what for who patient what patient who receive adjuvant treatment patient with stage 1 to 4A who undergo surgery without macroscopic disease. Okay. Adjuvant treatment recommendation strongly depend on prognostic risk groups. Prognostic risk groups, the definition of prognostic risk group, we follow the European Association of Gynecology Oncology, والاسترو, European Association of Radiation and Oncology, والEuropean Association of Pathology. There is a guidelines and the definition of the risk groups. The risk
so, by
groups.
The way, these guidelines are going to be renewed next year, so we'll have new guidelines, ESGO, ESTRO, ESP, by 2025, inshallah.
Okay. Yeah, just enumeration. The adjuvant treatment, endometrial carcinoma is a diverse group. There is a different groups of endometrial carcinoma, different prognosis, different pathological subtypes. And there is a diverse group. We should classify the patients, the risk groups. Poor patient will have the adjuvant treatment. Okay? Low, intermediate, high intermediate, high. والادفانسد والميتاستاتيك. اللي هو ستيج 1 اندومتريويد اللي هو الفيفربل هيستولوجي اند لو جريد نيجاتيف ليمف فاسكولار سبيس انفيجن اور فوكال. فوكال مينز نيجاتيف سنجل سبيس سنجل بوزيتيف ليمف فاسكولار سبيس. اوكي انترميديت ريسك a tumor more depth, عمل invasion more than the half myometrium with low grade or low grade with or stage 1A invasion less than half the myometrium with high grade. Okay? Or this group not well studied, not enrolled in many randomized trials. اللي هم ايه بقى الستيج دي بقى الستيج اللي عليها كونتروفيرسي البروبلماتيك هو ستيج 1A نون اندومتريويد اللي هو الاجريسيف اللي هو السيروس اور الكلير اور اندفرنشيت كارسينوما كارسينو ساركوما الميكسد اللي هو الانفيفرابل هيستولوجي with without myometrial invasion limited for endometrium only. هي ستيج 1 بس limited for endometrium only. No invasion in myometry. It is intermediate risk. Okay? High intermediate presence of lymphovascular space in invasion, substantial. Okay, it is high intermediate risk. Okay, or stage 1 endometrial regardless the depth of invasion with lymphovascular space invasion substantial. Okay, خلاص. Stage 2. Or stage 1B endometrioid high grade. And high intermediate risk in stage 1 endometrioid with lymphovascular space invasion substantial. Or stage 1B endometrioid high grade regardless lymphovascular space invasion. But stage 1B was high grade. Okay? Or stage 2 خرجنا من اليوترس بقى and invade cervix. الهاي stage 3 to 4A with no residual disease. This group who will receive the adjuvant treatment. No microscopic disease. No macroscopic disease. Stage 1 to 4A, non-endometrioid, serous, clear cell undifferentiated, اللي هو unfavorable with myometrial invasion. Stage 1 here, كانت without endometrial myometrial invasion and unknown endometrioid كانت intermediate. With myometrial invasion and unfavorable histology بقينا high. في أبديت للتي ان الفيجو ستيجنج 2023. الاندوميتريال كارسينوما الستيجنج الفيرست كان جاينكولوجي اونكولوجي جروب 33 دون ذا ستيجنج لابوراتومي اللي هي الفيجو ستيجنج كانت 1980 انتل 209 الفيجو ستيجنج اللي كنا شغالين بيها لسه من كام شهر. الابديت ده بقى بتاع الستيجنج الجديد عمل ايه بقى؟ دخل الفيروس هيستولوجيكال تايب تقريبا الريسك جروب اللي انا قلتها دي ده عملوها في التي ان في الايه في الايه في الفيجو ستيجنج. الفيروس هيستولوجيكال تايب التيومر باترن المقصود بيه الليمفوفاسكولار سبيس انفيجن والميوكولار كالسيفيكيشن نون اور نون اور ان نون. يعني this new staging improved the understanding of complex nature of several types of endometrial carcinoma. Short review on the staging. Stage 1, stage 1 A و B و C. 1 A1 non-aggressive histological type limited to polyp or confined to the endometrium. Stage 1 A2 non-aggressive involving less than 50% of myometrium with no focal lymphovascular space invasion as defined by the WHO. يعني the focal single. 1A3 low grade endometrial carcinoma limited to the uterus with simultaneous low grade endometrioid ovarian involvement. This stage should differentiate from stage 3 if there is involvement of adnexia. In these situations, the ovary should be the pathology low grade and the capsule of the ovary is intact. Stage 1B, non aggressive histological type. اللي هو الاندوميتريويد باثولوجي involving 50% or more than the myometry with no lymphovascular space invasion or focal lymphovascular space invasion. No lymphovascular or focal. When I said lymphovascular space invasion, I mean substantial. Okay? Focal, we mean there is a single site of lymphovascular space invasion. Stage 1C, aggressive histological type, serous, high grade endometrial cell carcinoma, carcinosarcoma, undifferentiated mixed, without any myometrial invasion. This means it is limited for the endometrium. Stages are stage 2, برضو classified into A, B, و C. وستيج 3 A و B و C. وستيج 4 ما فيش there is no difference from the previous staging of 2009. Adjuvant treatment. Low risk patient. There is no adjuvant treatment is recommended. For patients with stage 1A, grade 1 or 2, with endometrioid type, no or focal lymphovascular space invasion. Adjuvant treatment is not recommended. There is no risk of recurrence. The adjuvant treatment is given for any patient. We should calculate the risk for local recurrence and the risk for distant metastasis. Okay? Intermediate risk, a diverse group. All these types is intermediate risk of endometrial carcinoma. Patient with stage 1A grade 3 endometriosis with no or focal lymphovascular space invasion with or patient with stage 1B grade 1 2 endometriosis type with no or focal lymphovascular space invasion, adjuvant treatment is brachytherapy. Adjuvant treatments provides brachytherapy, adjuvant brachytherapy provide excellent vaginal control and high survival rate similar to those patients who received external beam. Brachytherapy is equivalent in this group for the patient who received external beam. We prefer brachytherapy for less side effects من الاكسترنال بي. Okay. Omission of adjuvant brachytherapy can be considered in this group. The trials concluded that those patients, there is no survival benefit. The benefit is decreased the risk of the recurrence for about 15% only. Patient with follow-up, we can catch the patient at early stage or patient well treated. So omission of the test and treatment in this group may be an option. We should put in mind the age of the patient. If the age more than 60, it is a risk factor. If there is two risk factors in bed, two risk factors of the patient, we should receive adjuvant treatment. This stage is a dilemma. Stage 1A, non-endometrioid disease without myometrium invasion, limited to the endometrium. Well, in this stage, we differentiate if the patient had negative peritoneal wash during surgery, peritoneal wash was done. If negative, there is option. Include vaginal brachy with or without systemic therapy. Non-endometrioid is aggressive subtypes. More risk for distant metastasis. We should add chemotherapy. Okay? Stage 1A, limited for the endometrium, there is a decreased risk for local recurrence, especially with adequate surgery. Type of patient character بتاعتهم اللي هي stage 1A non-endometrioid limited to the endometrium, not enrolled in randomized trials. يعني there is a defect on the data about this situation. There is options. Okay? But we follow if there is negative peritoneal wash, we should differentiate يعني or wait the condition of the patient, the age of the patient, and it shows maybe systemic therapy with brachytherapy or observation. There is a negative peritoneal wash. If the wash is positive, سبق السيف العزل خلاص اتحلت. The patient should receive systemic therapy and brachytherapy. Systemic therapy, it is a high grade for aggressive subtypes. For possibility or high possibility of distant metastasis, should receive systemic therapy, vaginal brachy for improve local control.
This is a very important point for the surgeons because, as we say always, when you are dealing with type 2 endometrial cancer with the non-endometrioid types, you should deal it like the ovarian cancer. So you do the cytology or the wash from the start and then start with the hysterectomy, blah, blah, blah. And usually the debate is when your colleague tell you why to do the wash, because the wash is not involved in the staging, either in the old staging or the new staging, but it differs in the prognosis. So it has a prognostic value. That's why you have to do the wash in the serous and the clear cell and carcinosarcomas.
High intermediate risk group for patients who undergo lymphadenectomy and pathological N3, N negative, sorry, pathologically node negative patient under complete surgery and do lymphadenectomy. Or central. I mean there is a pathological confirmation node negative pathologically. Okay. For what patient? For patient with stage 1A and 1B with lymphovascular space invasion. Or stage 1B grade 3. Or stage grade 2. Or stage 2 with grade 1. With substantial lymphovascular space invasion or stage 2, grade 2, 3. The patient should receive adjuvant treatment. No omission for adjuvant treatment. There is a high risk of recurrence and distant metastasis. We should review every case by case. There is endometrial carcinoma is a diverse group. We should know the age more than 60 or less. It is a factor. Okay, the general condition of the patient, the operations done. Okay, a lymphovascular space invasion, the high grade pathology. Adjuvant brachytherapy can be recommended to decrease the vaginal recurrence. External beam radiotherapy can be considered for what patients who have substantial lymphovascular space invasion or stage 2. Why? To decrease
nodal recurrence.
The nodal recurrence. Adjuvant chemotherapy may be added for this group, especially for high grade and substantial lymphovascular space invasion for possibility of high risk of distant metastasis.
Yes. So it's again, I think it's very disturbing for the gynecologist, sure. For the oncosurgeon. But okay. What I usually recommend, this will not be studied by heart in one presentation, but usually when you finish your case and then you receive the final pathology, please don't just refer for the clinical oncologist. Just go and try to do the exercise with your mind. You can go through the ESGO mobile algorithm. You can go to the ESGO application mobile algorithm or through the NCCN guidelines. Yes. And then you can see and you can do a conversation with your patient and tell him that you have the option of 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1, 2, 3 for this. And you should understand that lymphoscar space invasion means a high risk of nodal recurrence. So that's why we should cover the pelvis by external beam, not by the adjuvant. Once you refer your patient for the clinical oncologist and then your patient hears the same scenarios from your clinical oncologist, he will be very confident in you and he will know that you are a competent gyne-oncologist. And again, sometimes they come back to me and said, we went for Dr. Ghada and she said, are going to observation. And we said, we went for Dr. Fulan and he said, no, we are going to brachy. So there is someone who is right and someone who is wrong. And so you tell him, no, you have the options and this is optional and you have this discussion. That's what differs a competent gyne-oncologist from just one who will finish his surgery and then refer to the clinical oncologist, okay?
You should review the pathological report.
Yes.
Very, very, very important. A high intermediate risk, clinically node negative, but pathologically NX, no, lymphadenectomy not performed.
Which is a very common scenario that we see here. Yes. We meet every week.
Whatever. Here, we start with external beam radiotherapy to cover the pelvic lymph node and the vaginal vault or paravaginal tissue to control for local control and eliminate any microscopic disease in lymph node. Okay? Additional of adjuvant chemotherapy may be considered, especially for what patient for high grade with substantial lymphovascular space invasion. Adjuvant brachytherapy may be considered in this situation for high intermittent risk for what patient? For patient, if there is a negative lymphovascular space invasion, stage 2 endometrium, grade 1 endometrioid, age less than 60.
So Dr. Gada, let's agree that those patients who are not, who haven't their nodes to be assessed surgically, you will not send them back. So we will not take them back to the OR to do lymphadenectomy. We're just going to assess if we're going to external beam or further than external beam according to the
clinically
lymphoma patient.
not
Yes,
negative,
clinically
clinically
negative.
radiology
Because what
that
usually happens
not
that the oncologist refer back to patients that this patient wasn't
couldn't
optimally,
prepare.
is not optimal surgical stage, and then the surgeon go and do lymphadenectomy for the patient. This is not the right. We should refer to the clinical oncologist if they are not the lymph node assessed to do external beam or whatever what they say, or brachy or whatever.
The treatment of the patient must be in multidisciplinary team to avoid the patient over treatment and over side effect of each type of treatment.
Combining surgery with radiation. Usually.
Okay. High risk. High risk group. The definition of high risk group for endometrial carcinoma has been challenged. Currently, stage 3, 4A endometrial carcinoma without residual disease. Or stage 1 to 4A non-endometrioid carcinoma without residual disease with myometrium invasion. The stage 1 previous slides, they get stage 1 in stage 1 non-endometrioid limited للإندومتريوم without myometrial invasion. She was intermediate risk. Okay, if there is myometrial invasion, it is a high risk group. In this situation, we give combined therapy, chemotherapy and radiotherapy. There is option external beam with concurrent chemotherapy or sequential chemotherapy with radiotherapy or chemotherapy alone in certain situations. Carcinosarcoma, we should treat it as a high risk carcinoma. The optimal sequence of chemotherapy and radiotherapy is a subject of controversy. Many centers prefer sequential, giving chemotherapy first, which is often based on logistic reasons. Start with chemotherapy, then radiotherapy, or the rationale for this situation. To in this situation, the patient is high risk. The aim of macroscopic distant metastasis is present. So start with chemotherapy is better to eliminate any microscopic disease. But there is published result from two recent large prospective randomized trials have shown the safety and activity of combined chemotherapy and radiotherapy schedules. And this schedules have the advantage of starting both adjuvant treatment immediately at the same time. The patient will give chemotherapy with the first and received weekly with the radiotherapy. For what patient the chemo radiation is better? The chemo radiations maximize the recurrence free and overall survival and pelvic and para-aortic nodal control in women with stage 3 disease and or serous histology. Those patients who will benefit from the combined concurrent chemo radiotherapy. Okay? What regimen of chemotherapy for knowledge? Taxol, carb. Carboplatin, paclitaxel, the most common adjuvant regimen. Concurrently, we give cisplatin weekly with the radiotherapy. As we said before, chemotherapy alone may be an alternative option. Okay? We may adding pelvic radiotherapy to brachytherapy. Pelvic and brachytherapy for some patient. For what patient? in high risk patient with deep myometrium invasion, more than 50% of myometrial invasion, stage B, or patient with lymphovascular space invasion, those patients get benefit from external beam and brachytherapy as an adjuvant. Okay? Systemic therapy, as we said, Taxol carb. يعني أنا مش هحاول إيه أدخلكم عشان ما إيه تتعبوش مني في في الشغل بتاعنا، يعني مجرد بس وي نو تاكسول كاربوبلاتين. أوكي، ذا ديفايس أو بريك ثيرابي إت إز ذا فيجينال بروب وي ستارت فيجينال بريك ثيرابي within 6 to 8 weeks after healing and the patient overcomes a post operative period. Okay, we give radiotherapy for what? For vaginal vault and upper third of the vagina. It is the sites may have microscopic cells. There is a different group. This is the planning. That is the probe, as well the radiations. External beam radiotherapy. Used to eliminate cancer cell that remain in the pelvis after surgery. We should start it within 6 to 8 weeks after the operation. There is a different doses and a different technique. You يعني, may know 3D conformal radiotherapy or IMRT. How we do external beam radiotherapy? The patient, we do planning of the patient, CT cut every 3 millimeter, and we define clinical target volume. It is the site of the upper vagina and the paravaginal tissue and pelvic lymph node. We see the artery and around the artery by 1.5 centimeter. We cover the pelvic lymph node. This is our machine, the machine of external beam radiotherapy. Okay? Hello, Anton. This is the adjuvant treatment. Any question? They are diverse group.
Yes, just Dr. Radwa was asking online that can we please relate to PORTIC trials, to the PORTIC trials? She is asking to correlate to the PORTIC trials. Correlate the adjuvant treatment with the PORTIC 1, PORTIC 2, PORTIC 3 trial. But this is it's the same that we have said. Yes.
It's a long-standing randomized trials. Recently, the most recent is molecular calcification.
Yes, it's PORTIC 4A.
Oh, it is the air.
Yes.
لأن هي فعلا يعني will change the endometrial carcinoma upside down.
It changed everything. All what we have said is dependent on the previous type 1 and type 2 endometrioid. But now, and as we have said in the last lecture, that PORTIC 1 was about adjuvant radiation, and then PORTIC 2, brachy plus external, and then PORTIC 3, chemo plus radiation. And now PORTIC 4A, they are studying the implication of molecular classification. And so all of this will be changed in the
will
next
be changed within
very few years.
5 years.
Shukran, Doctora. Can I ask a question? When we're talking about the high risk group, it says in without post operative, without residual disease. And then we didn't mention with the residual disease. If you
residual
with
disease,
residual...
it is the advanced. The definition, it
so
is
without,
the advanced.
Oh, so without residual disease basically means, and I did.
I differ the stage. The stage is different. It is advanced disease.
Oh, no, after 4A.
Advanced disease include stage 3, 4A with residual disease.
So once you have residual disease, it's advanced.
It is advanced.
By default. Brilliant.
After surgery?
Yes, after surgery.
After surgery. The definition of the treatment is different. I give adjuvant. Adjuvant treatment is given for microscopic disease, no macroscopic. If there is a macroscopic disease, there is no adjuvant.
This
Adjuvant
treatment
is
now.
even to eliminate microscopic disease. Okay?
So again, going to the basics, neoadjuvant, is that what you give before surgery or before the definitive treatment, either surgery or something? And the adjuvant is what you give after surgery to enhance. Alpha, that's what we call by Arabic. This is we give the treatment prophylactic for use this adjuvant. This is why, and you give it curative. So some patient you refer, if she is serous endometrial carcinoma stage 1A, you give her the adjuvant treatment as prophylaxis to decrease recurrence and relapse. But if it is metastatic, you give the main line of treatment is systemic treatment. This is curative. احنا ندي علاج كيماوي وقائي ولا بندي علاج كده؟ احنا بنترجمها كده يعني. But this is the
adjuvant is يعني معناها بالعربي مكمل.
مساعد.
يعني primary patient treated with surgery with no macroscopic.
If it is advanced, if you have parametrium infiltration, if you have deep cervical or going to the vagina, if you have some peritoneal nodules, for example, and you remove the peritoneal nodules, so if you leave any peritoneal
there is
nodules,
residual disease.
You can leave residual disease. Yes, it's very common, especially in type 2 endometrial cancer. In type 2, just you explore your patient. For example, it is not well prepared, and then it's a serous or clear cell. You find peritoneal nodules, you find omentum, you find something. Okay, so you remove the uterus. You couldn't remove all the peritoneal nodules. You are not trained to do omentectomy or something like this, and then you left the residual disease behind. Or if you have, for example, peritoneal parametrium infiltration going to the pelvic side wall, for example, and so you do debulking of the disease and left some residual in the pelvic or something like that. Sometimes even it is going to the cervix to the vagina, and then you cut the lower specimen and you have residual disease in the pathology report. It's because the vaginal itself margin is involved by the disease. So all of these are advanced disease.
The aim of the treatment of adjuvant treatment?
Yes. No, this is...
All these patients.
Yes.
All this category.
No one will leave a residual. No one will leave residual with the stage one disease, but because they said it's from stage one to stage four. So in stage four, you may leave a residual disease, but no one eventually will leave in stage one. Yes.
We should differ.
Yes. It means that stage four, no. It means that stage four has the same prognosis like stage one, yes.
Okay. Aim, we should differentiate. The aim of treatment of adjuvant is curative. We're aiming for cure.
Yes.
Okay? We eliminate any microscopic disease. In this situation, if it is advanced disease, my aiming is palliative.
Yes. No, and
okay?
still you have
No.
stage one, which for example, the patient has done a subtotal hysterectomy. This is the common scenario that we see. So subtotal hysterectomy, and then you have the lower endometrial margin involved by the disease. This is stage one with residual disease, which is not advanced, okay? So now he turned it into advanced. So you should have treatment or remove it. This is a scenario, another scenario. This we see.
Okay. Welcome. Advanced disease include stage 3, 4A with residual disease. There is a macroscopic disease in the pelvis, in the abdomen. Metastatic include stage 4B, distant metastasis. Okay? 4B, distant metastasis. The outcome of advanced or recurrent disease remains poor. The 5-year overall survival is about 20%. My aim of treatment is palliative aim. Okay? Adjuvant, my aim is curative. Treatment options should guided by a patient condition, general condition of the patient, extent of the disease, the previous therapy, and molecular profile. Surgery may be an option for this group of patients for limited cases of this group. Patient with general condition is very good. We can do surgical tumor bulking, including enlarged lymph node with macroscopic resection. Those patients should discussed in multidisciplinary team. Okay, if the surgery can do surgical debulking without residual, with accepted morbidity and adequate life profile for the patient, maybe it is an option for highly selected cases. In this situation, may give systemic, primary systemic chemotherapy, your adjuvant chemotherapy, aiming for downstaging of the tumor. Then assessment of the chemotherapy response. If the patient can be candid for surgery, it is better to do surgery. Okay? In certain situations, if there is a good response of systemic therapy and all the disease, there is a marked response and the disease is disappear. There is no surgery. We will wait, okay? Radiotherapy, we discuss the options of locally advanced or recurrent disease, okay? Surgery, as we said, radiotherapy, the patient who is locally advanced may present it with bleeding, severe pain. Those patients can benefit from radiotherapy. Radiotherapy will improve the pain and the bleeding. If the patient is not candidate for surgery or not candidate for chemotherapy, systemic therapy is a primary treatment for advanced disease. We will do in the next slide. Definitive, what I mean by definitive radiotherapy? Curative. Definitive is curative. We do the maximum dose. There is no hope of surgery. We give the patient the total dose, okay, for improved local control, external beam, and brachytherapy. Intrauterine brachytherapy is a sole modality used for low-grade early disease. The combination with external intracavitary brachytherapy is recommended for high-grade tumor or with deep myometrial invasion to improve local control. Systemic therapy. For advanced relapsed disease, not candidate for surgery or radiotherapy. It is the standard approach remains for advanced disease. It is the chemotherapy or hormonal therapy. Hormonal therapy has been accepted as a first line therapy for advanced endometrial carcinoma, with safety profile and attractive therapeutic approach for selected group of patients. For what patient I give hormonal therapy? For low grade or patient with ER or BR positive? Okay.
Again, who are not surgical candidates. For example, they are very old and they are morbid, and this is what's been,
yeah. We deal with the advanced, not candidate for, as we said, for surgery or radiotherapy. For those patients, we can give hormones.
And again, I believe, Dr. Ghada, and if the disease is far advanced beyond the pelvis, so if you have an upper abdominal disease or disseminated proteinuria nodules, so this is outside the field of radiation, you will not give radiation for the whole abdomen, right?
Right. The standard treatment is hormonal and progestin and anti-estrogen, all types of anti-estrogen, the tamoxifen or vasodexa or aromatase inhibitor, chemotherapy. The standard of care is carbo, taxocarb, okay? Or taxocarb with the bevacizumab, Avastin. But the bevacizumab failed to demonstrate clear benefit with progression-free survival. I said progression-free survival, okay? Mm-hmm. with respect to the standard of care. Usually we use the same regimen as we used in cancer ovary. We use it with endometrial carcinoma. Chemotherapy options beyond the first line therapy are limited. No standard of care. Palliative options, taxanes or doxorubicin, or all types, the azacitidine, nevirapine, whatever, there is limited activity. If the patient does not respond for the first line, there is no expected response from the second or the third line. As we said, we mimic the ovarian cancer. The concept of platinum sensitivity, if the patient progressed after 6 months, we can rechallenge by the same regimen, Taxol-Carb. Re-irradiation, this slide, we should know that re-irradiation is very important for highly selected patients. في بيشنت انا كنت بعتها لكم برضه يا دكتور من كام سنه برضه كانت سيرجري عمل السيرجري وكان بعد السيرجري في وكانت واخده راديو ثيرابي وبعد في ريزيدوال وعملت سيرجري في الاول بعد الريكرنس بعد او بعد الراديشن كالادجفنت بتاعها وكان دلوقتي كان في تشانس بعد السيرجري سكند سيرجري كان في بوزيتيف ماكروسكوبيك
مارجنز
most of مارج انا we can do re-irradiation in certain situation for what patient that is pelvic lymph node or left side wall we can re-irradiate the patient it is important option حضرتك يا دكتور باسل قلت على الاميون تشيك بوينت في ال
yes
اوكي
Yeah, but it must be mentioned. This is very important now for
it is an options.
Yes.
The immune checkpoint will
is a new key player.
والبيمبرو والكلام الكبير ده انا بس ايه two important point the future direction will hope will hope for treatment of endometrial carcinoma CDK inhibitor CDK inhibitor مفعلة معانا في البريست في الحالات اللي هي هرمونال بوزيتيف هير تو نيجاتيف
CDK4
امبروف الافيكاسي اوف هرمونال تريتمنت اوكي ذير از 3 تايبس اوف CDK4/6 انهيبيتور وات ايفر اند هير تو كارسينوساركوما اند سيروس كارسينوما اباوت 25% is positive for HER2. We can target by Herceptin. Okay?
Yes.
Thank you. I hope yeah. كنت ضيف خفيف.
Thank you. Very, very nice.
أنا حاولت أقصى إن أنا أختصر الترايلز بتاعتنا لأن
yes.
هي حاجة مؤذية وحاجة كلها بتدخل في بعضها وحاجة صعبة. بحاول عملت كونكلوجن اعصر الترايلز عشان ما بقاش ضيف مؤذي بصراحه.
لا لا it was very nice for a general gynecologist or an oncosurgeon. Again I wish that we had like much time for the immune therapy and pembrolizumab because this is now it's not the future it's what's happening right now because we had the approvals in 2023 and 2024 to add the pembrolizumab. Yes, pembrolizumab. Yes. Yes. So now you do the mismatch repair, as we said, and if there is mismatch repair deficient, this would be the category of patient who would benefit much from having Keytruda or pembrolizumab. And now they are FDA approval, and then you can add to lovitanib and or other combinations of immune therapy. So, because this would be a very important point for them in the exam. Yes, but they are going to have it in the exam mostly. Yes, and CDK4/6 is very important. And Enhertu, we have the Enhertu now. I believe it is found in Egypt. It's in the Enhertu, which is the. Yes, yes. No, but because they are studying for the ESO exam, so they must know it that we use it anti-HER2 which is the inheritor, which I believe it is found now. Yes. Just the mic for the physical. Because we have a question, Dr. Ghada from Dr. Mina Nagy. He's saying that when we use tamofen in breast cancer, it increases the risk of endometrial carcinoma. And then now you mentioned that it's treatment option for endometrial carcinoma, and he doesn't understand this point. How tamofen is high risk for endometrial cancer and how we use it for endometrial cancer treatment.
Okay. We give hormonal treatment anti-estrogen.
Yes.
It is, the disease is already present.
Yes.
Okay. The patient is ER and BR positive. The rationale is the mechanism of action. Mechanism of action, it is anti-estrogen.
Yes.
Okay.
And I believe we use more, for example, we use it for the fertility insufficient, the antiprogesterone, Zemigas, and all the antiprogesterone more than using tamofen for.
We already use aromatase inhibitor.
They are positive, PR positive patients.
We give the patient aromatase inhibitor, which is Aromedex.
Aromedex.
Aromedex or Femara.
Yes.
Well, after that, Vasludex, but the cost.
Yes.
هي الكوست بنفيت اند جنرال كونديشن اوف ذا بيشنت والريسورسز هي اللي بتاخد تتحكم في الديسيجن بتاع التريتمنت اللي بقدر اديه. اوكي.
So, do we have any other questions for Professor Ghada? Dr. Amr has a question.
شكرا دكتور غدا على
المحاضرة
اللطيفة. أنا سؤالي في موضوع اللي هو الراديشن after surgery اللي هو 6 to 8 weeks.
تمام.
After that, the patient lost the chance for radiation, or I can delay if I cover by chemotherapy. يعني
if the external beam, لو external beam radiotherapy or brachytherapy, it is the only treatment. The decision of the treatment is external beam or brachytherapy alone. For early stage, okay, adjuvant treatment should given within 6 months. Tumor doubling time, well, if there is a microscopic disease, we should give the patient within 6 months. After 6 months, there is no benefit.
يعني لو عدى الثمان أسابيع لسه في فرصة إنه ياخذ رديء.
For 6 months, for the tumor doubling time, will be no microscopic disease. We eliminate microscopic. Okay, within 6 months, we give the adjuvant treatment. The aim will be changed if there is macroscopic disease. Okay.
Okay, doctor. السؤال الثاني. فكرة في recurrent disease. إحنا دائما عندنا فكرة إنه patient receive radiotherapy or not. هي الفترة إنه لو أخذ فعليا radiotherapy قد إيه الفترة المسموحة عشان أنا re-irradiate here.
Re-irradiation is a dilemma. Recent trials give re-irradiation after 6 months. We should have a calculations for the more specific for the radiotherapy regimen and the dose given and the organ at risk at the sites. We decide if the patient can give re-irradiation or not. But more than 6 months, the patient may give may take re-irradiation again, more than 6 months from the previous external, from the previous radiotherapy regimen. يعني ممكن أعيد الراديوثيرابي بre-irradiation عادة بعد 6 شهور. دي دايلما كبيرة في حساباتنا احنا في الراديوثيرابي. لها حسابات كده ومعادلة بحسب انا يعني بحسب عشان السايد افكت. انا دلوقتي بدي ري الراديشن الاولاني في عندي سايد افكت على الاورجن اتريسك اللي جنبي، في عندي على البلادر، في عندي على الريكتوم، في حسب السايد هو اللوكال ريكارنس ده فين او بلفيك سايد وول. تمام. لو انا قريبه من الهيد اوف ذا فيمر لها حسابات معينه برجع احسب الاورجن اتريسك اللي هي النورمال تيشو ده اخد ايه. ثانيا الري الراديشن اند بديه بهاي تكنيك من الراديو ثيرابي، عاده بستخدم على الاقل 3 دي او اي ام ار تي. اوكي.
يعني هو انت عشان فكرة ال6 شهور، احنا اخذنا في وقت الكيموثيرابي انه اقل من 6 شهور ريزيستنس. هل الموضوع هذا موجود كمان في الراديوثيرابي؟
لا الراديوثيرابي
يعني
في
خاصة انا
ديفرنشال
لما اعتبره انه ديفينيتيف راديوثيرابي، يعني انه هل انه لو انه هعمل ري راديشن بعد 6 شهور؟
ري راديشن يعني سبيشال سيتويشن not all the cases can give her ray radiation. I calculate
انساها
the
دي
dose.
خالص، يعني forget about radiation now.
ده انا قلتها for
It's reserved
certain
for
patients.
يعني
انا
certain
كانت في
conditions
الام دي تي
زي
مع
ال
الدكتور
DTS.
باسل فاكرها، فكنا يعني برضو والبيشنت جيت بنفيت من ري الراديشن. بيشنت ستيل ريزيدوال ريزيفت كيموثيرابي وعمل سيرجري وفي عنده ريزيدوال 5 سم كده واخده راديو ثيرابي قبل كده، بيحتاج هاي يعني هاي تكنيك في الراديو ثيرابي ولها حساباتها الخاصه سوفيستيكيتد معانا احنا.
very very special situation after MDT okay and after the clinical oncologist will permit
مش كل
irradiation
الحالات اقدر اعمل لها ري راديشن،
and
مش كل
usually
حاجه،
after a long period from the primary irradiation okay
هي ممكن بعد 6 شهور يعني
yes
فيها بوينت اوف ديبيت this situation زي يعني.
so do we have any other questions so thank you Professor Ghadir so much for your time and next week we are going to meet with our beloved Dr. Mohammad Hamdi is going to speak about uterine sarcoma Next week, we still have the whole September for retraining. We will finish the endometrial carcinoma by the end of September, and then we'll start the cervical in October, inshallah. So thank you for your time. And as usual, the presentation is recorded and it would be uploaded in the EGO's YouTube channel and the EGO's website. So check them if you want to restudy it again. Thank you and good night.